the next one?
What's the next one?
Is this a vampire teenager?
I think so. I never watched it.
I watched it, but a really long time ago.
Lost Boys. The light is awful, but bear with me. I watched that when I was 11 or so, and it was such a ridiculous movie that I forgot all about it. And watching it again, no, it's boring. The only memorable thing is the bottle. So that's what will happen. I will transform myself into the bottle. Let's do this. The materials. After some extended research on the internet, I was able to come up with this sketch. And this will be my guide to the bottle.
I have this thick cotton satin that I will transform into the bottle. I need first a cylinder. And for that, I will make a sort of hoop skirt of death again.
Shoo! Nay! Stop! No! Thank you!
The skirt!
First, I need the measurements of my low hip. My widest part is my low hip. Last time I checked, 113 with all the clothes I have on. That means I will make a circumference of 125 just to be safe. 140 sewing channels.
One eternity later.
Shut up! Well, now it's full with cat hair, sushi hair, dust, and my pants are golden. I will do what I never thought I would do in my life. Desperate measures. Look at this! Even my socks are golden now. Can you see my face? It exploded everywhere. Definitely not have enough now. I lost at least one third with these shenanigans.
Another eternity later.
Mix some of this pink to make a little bit more blood-like. I don't know about you, but my blood is pink. Because I'm a unicorn!
The Lost Boys is still by me and my non-functioning brain. I might be having a stroke in this video, or I'm just high on the paint fumes because it's so hard to find the words for sentences and making sense today. Oof! Spoiler alert, as usual. I should have forgotten this story and not Pennywise, by the way. This is so boring. So this family moves from somewhere to somewhere else to live with the stoner grandpa who's addicted to taxidermy, and mom is recently divorced, so she needs a date and a job ASAP. They go to this fair and she meets Gilmore Max and gets both already. How convenient. Gilmore Max also has an evil sushi, by the way. Then the boys are messing around and the older one sees this girl, Star, and instantly starts creepy stalking her. But she's with Mudlet Sutherland and his gang. Smaller brother is in a comic book store and meets two weirdos that tell him about vampires in town, and they are vampire hunters apparently. So Discount Henry Cavill goes partying with the gang and they peer pressure him into drinking from this very fancy bottle, although Star tells him not to because it's Mudlet Sutherland's blood. But he does it anyway, and they jump from a bridge and apparently he's a vampire now and has an earring. Smaller dude is over that shit and calls the vampire hunters that want to kill Discount Cavill, but smaller dude doesn't let them, so they figure out that they need to kill the master vampire to make all half vampires normal again. They suspect that Gilmore Max is the boss vampire man because of evil sushi. But mom goes apeshit when they start acting up during dinner time and doesn't believe them. Things start happening and in the end, they are all being attacked in the house because they want to kill Mullet Sutherland since now he is the only viable option for being the ultra vampire, and Star's brother transforms into the Chupacabra out of nowhere and Sutherland gets killed. Nothing happens to anyone, then Gilmore Max arrives and plot twist, he was the Maxi vampire all along! And wow, we never saw that one coming! So Grandpa drives him over and kills him, everyone is back to normal, and Grandpa finishes with, "One thing about living in Santa Carla, I never could stomach all the damn vampires. So he knew it all along." Wow, such storytelling. Much movie. Such beautiful.
So that's it for the blood red on the skirt for now. Just need to figure out what will I use here for our gold. Haha, I'm not buying new paint. I have copper spray and I have gold spray. But I'll make some tests and I'll be right back.
12 seconds later.
It's not dry yet, but from what I could see, the spray is not an option. It's kind of the same color, but it's not as shiny. Why did I have to let it fall down? Let me check my stash. Maybe I still have some in the back. There's this other color. It's a little bit darker than this super gold that I used. And the camera's rolling. Oh no! My piñata! My dragon! Well, maybe I could use those. This is almost full. This is empty. But I could try to shake a little bit of life out of this. And maybe I will not let it go down this time. Damn! Are you freaking serious? Guess what happened with the... Oh no!
Das ist so loco.
Yes!
Wir sind überall Nadeln und Kackepup.
Kackepup?
Kackepup von die Hundi-Hund.
Nein. Oh.
Was machst du denn?
Gold wins everything! Get to this corner here and there's a lot of paint there. Can I get to this? I have nothing that makes this curve. Why are our small spoons so big? They don't fit in my paint bucket. Because no one wanted the mini spoons. I got them, but I left them in Brazil. And now that I need the mini spoons. Why? The spoons were too small? I want brownies. Whoa, what do you mean with no? Your mom can go to Rewe by herself brownies. You have sushi? Sushi is a virgin.
She had a period, she's not a virgin.
What?
This is how that works!
I think it's time I explain to Steve how the female anatomy works. Oh my god. Now, for those of you wondering, this is non-toxic paint. Or I at least I hope so. They don't say. It could be toxic. Scent. You might lose your fingers if you come into close contact. Thank you. I'm surrounded by wildlings. Oh, this is so pretty. Look at that. It's like a lake. And it's all gold. It's molten gold. Molten gold. Oh, I'm seriously tripping on this paint right now. It's not supposed to be a toxic paint. What are you doing over there? Animal, you know you're not supposed to be there. What do you want? Hopefully without major incidents now. Oh, it's the same color. I'm emotional.
Meanwhile, in the kitchen.
Thank you.
brownies.
The other side is finished, but the paper is still pretty much stuck to this. But we'll use the evil vodka to maybe soften the paper and release it from the fabric. Helped a little bit, yes, but not a lot. Oh, it's working. It's working a lot. Looks so much better already. Oh.
Be careful with color that you have to heat seal before you wash it because it's kind of coming off. But I'll just leave this here very quiet to dry before I touch it again.
And now I need to do some math because I need to make the transition from the bottle to my waist. This part of the bottle.
What?
This thing is called a frustum. 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 Whoa! What the hell is this?
What?
There are so many pies and oh my god. I tell you I'm stupid. I don't need to calculate anything. Let's paint this red. Let's just hope Sushi doesn't get near it. This is the waistband for the skirt.
Golden!
Ew. Look what seeps through from the gold paint. Like all the gold stays on the fabric, but the base paint seeps through. And it's a weird brown. Ugh.
Diarrhea brown. Diarrhea brown.
Jeez, it looks like I'm about to summon the devil or something.
Shadows in place.
Let's paint some highlights.
And hopefully not mess this up.
The top.
Yeah, I don't have any more of the golden paint.
That's a problem, because I still need to do the upper part of the... You know, I cut the upper part of my bell dress again. You know, the one with this. Because this will be the cork. The lid. What's the name? The screw? The thing that closes the bottle. Yes. And what I found that I still have.
Quite a bit.
The golden monstrosity. So, let's get going.
Ugh.
It's spooky in a whole new level.
Look at the shimmer. It feels as plasticky as it looks.
Everything's sewn in.
Words. Words? No. No words.
This is my shoulder strap, beautiful shoulder strap. And this is the back shoulder strap.
My brain is doing weird stuff again.
I don't know.
One of the things that annoyed me the most about the Rolls Royce was the fact that I could not change the presser feet without using this tiny screwdriver.
There is this piece that's supposed to make some magic. It's a 3 feet holder and it magically moves. So you can leave always 3 feet there and it rotates on itself. A tourette allows the attachment of 3 feet, fits most lock stitch machine.
And this I bought directly from the supplier, so I did not pay 70 bucks for this. I don't remember how much I paid it though. Mechanic assist may be necessary to properly fit the head and remove the external thread wiper. Oh, damn. Let's see.
So I had already changed the screw for this one that I can't loosen with my hand. It's not the best option ever. Sometimes it comes loose and the foot disappears.
What the heck is this? Oh, this is the adjustment thing for the height of the presser foot, I think. I'll just leave this here.
Okay, now I understand what they meant.
That is stupid.
Oh no, I can't use it.
This was way too good to be true. I have to remove the external thread cutter, this thing here. At least I have 2 new feet. I have a zipper foot and a piping foot.
Why?
I will test without the external wiper for now and see how I manage with it. Because sometimes the internal cutter cuts the upper thread as well. The thing is always hitting my finger anyways. So it's a little dangerous. How many nails I have broken with the external thread wiper. It's very unfair. Lost boy bottle. Bottle is not filled up to the top. Here it needs to be a bottle color. What is a bottle color? This weird bluish color, right?
Or am I insane?
boning.
Now it's time to insert the metal boning in the skirt, and you all know how good I am at that.
The thing that I need is not in the toolbox.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
Damn you! Whatever.
Let's improvise.
Can't get in there.
I can't see anything. Why do I do this? Thank you that you come to my rescue. I can't see anything. I need to prop it up.
Why do I do this? No, get in there. It's hard to breathe in here. Ooh, ow, my arms.
Ooh, my knee. Ow. Oh. It's kind of working, but not really, so I have to figure something else out. I will insert one very large boning piece as a spiral inside of that. So I'm going to be a huge jump out of the box snake. Whee! Another dream come true for me.
So she's helping me insert boning.
I'm inside the bottle. Welcome to my tent. I live here now, and I don't plan on coming out anytime soon. It's very cozy in here. I think it's even waterproof, or at least a little bit water repellent.
This is the view of my new quarters. It's very cozy. I have enough space, so I don't asphyxiate.
But other than that, it's a very minimalistic life. Totally recommend. Yeah, even light can come in a very flattering way. Look. I have light shining in a very woo way. Goodbye.
I'm going to die. Today's the day I die. They spin the bottle. I can't spin from my figure skating days.
I don't think I can. I'm scared.
I can't really move.
Bet, come ahead.
You're a bet. You're on service right now.
Hello! I'm talking to you. Why did you stand up? Go, bet.
Leave the balloon. The balloon is dead. There's no more balloon. So how does it feel to be a bottle? Very annoying because I cannot walk. I depend on the bed to move around. I'm full with blood, which is disgusting. And people put their mouth on my head constantly. That's very disturbing.
No, no.
She's in a working position, so she will not be disturbed.
Such hard work!
She's a bet. She's a transport bet.
Much work. Know.
I always test my dresses for the runaway, in case I need to run away from weirdos. This is definitely not safe for running away situations.
But now let's test if I can sit down.
I just hope not to be impaled by any rogue wires in the skirt.
This is a very sad sitting situation.
Sitting sad. Oh.
I love you so much, my service bet.
Yeah, why are you biting me? You're on top of me.
Yes, now I'm gonna clean your drool on your face. Because you're disgusting. If I need to go to the bathroom, just pull this up. And it's the snake in a box situation. You know the snake in a box? Because I did a spiral.
Something nasty.
Ew! No! Those springy snakes! I told them already. The way I put the boning inside of this curtain. You're nasty!
Something nasty.
The way I
the
put
snake. The snake.
The
snake.
Way I put the boning in the thing is a spiral. Like those snakes that you press and then you put it somewhere small, and then when you open the something small, it jumps on your face. You had no childhood.
No, I'm German.
Oh, I forget about
that. I played with potatoes.
And conkers.
And conkers. Who else played with conkers and matches?
He told me a very sad story of him making puppets with conkers and matches and...
And now every day children come and get the conkers?
There was a woman driving her daughter around and asking could collect the conkers in our guard. Go ahead, take them away. I don't want them. Just take them! This was a lot of work for a very boring movie. And a very boring, I don't know what to do with this, because I cannot move.
What do you say? Am I a professional bottle now? Can I put this on my resume?
Spin the bottle! I have failed in life. At least it's easy to put away.